scheduled for 12. McDonough surviving the first round. He was knocked down twice in the opening round.
And again, his only hope here is to try to punch out as he did at the very opening minute of the first round. But it's simply class that's telling here. It's two different class fighters here. One guy is ballroom brawling, and the other guy is a fine scientific fighter, finely honed, finely conditioned, and we're seeing prime Holyfield here.
Now Holyfield working the jab.
Holyfield will hit him with a jab, control him with a jab. Suddenly he'll turn a hook off that jab, cross the right hand, and down will go Sheamus. There has been a noticeable absence of body shots here. Holyfield had said, I want to work his body a little bit and get his hands down. He has not done that.
The fans getting behind Sheamus McDuddy can hear the chanting in the background, trying to urge him on, but Holyfield again. There's a combination by Evander Holyfield.
There's that right hand that comes off the jab. When he turns the hook off the jab, he can catch Sheamus, who's just leaning that way. I mean, he's just ready for a left hook.
There's another left by Holyfield. Oh, McDonough just being punished.
He's got to start putting some punches together, or else he is going to eat leather for what's left of this short fight.
Settling down somewhat here to the advantage of Sheamus McDuddy.
It's a one-way fight to this point, but Holyfield is letting him off the hook. Maybe indeed he feels like he needs this work. It certainly is nothing but a gym workout at this point.
Well, we addressed that issue at the outset, and maybe that is the case, but he told us in a meeting yesterday that he is going for the early knockout.
And so did Georgie Benton, his trainer, and so did Lou Duva, and so did everybody in his corner. Get him out of there as fast as you can is the message that was sent to Holyfield.
When you have that many millions at stake, that's got to be the philosophy.
Remember, anything here, a broken hand, a cut, a broken nose, anything could set him back off a $10 million shot. So his backers have got to be very nervous as round two winds down with very little action compared to the first round.
And that'll do it for the second round.
Sheamus, you got to punch. Now let's go. Punch. Don't stand there. You're move. Punch. Move. Punch.
Punch with him.
All right.
What? Come on. I think you saw
hit him and hurt him. Don't go. Kill him. Take him out of there.
Right? Boxing beauty. That jab come right back with those combinations. 3-4 punch combinations.
Right. Hands up the mat. So in case he comes running out after you, try to key with something. Okay. You know what I'm saying? Save it round. You go out there with this guy. You got to have your hands up.
Let's go, champ. Let's do it this round. Let's do it. Come on. Let's go. Get that body.
It is round three. McDonough surviving two knockdowns in the first round. Didn't go down in the second round. Evander Holyfield wearing the words blood salvage on his trunks. That's not his new nickname. He's still the real deal, but it's a phrase that is really contradictory to his personality. He is certainly a gentleman outside the ring as things open up once again. That's the name of a movie he's in. Combination by McDonough as he comes back.
That's the only thing he can do. He must fight back. He must use both hands to try to keep Holyfield away.
Down goes McDonough for the third time in that one count. It's a slip, a trip.
Coming from the side of Sheamus's left eye. It's right in his brow, not a big factor right now, just a nick. Holyfield was told, keep your hands up, jab, and and use that combination, and let's get him out of there this round. Those were the orders from Luduva, and those were the orders from Georgie Benn, the cornerman of Holyfield.
Did you notice Holyfield stumbled? And that got a rise out of the crowd. Holyfield bouncing around, looking very sharp.
Duva's hollering from the corner, double up the jab, and is... as if on order from the master, he's doubling up that jab. Both of them landing on the brow of Sheamus.
Ooh, that left by Holyfield to the midsection of McDonough. A little bit of a low blow there by Holyfield. Got away with it.
Holyfield actually fighting a sort of lazy fight. That blazing first round and inactive second round, he's not really pressuring, he's not putting on pressure, almost as if he's willing to be patient and take it as it comes. As we spoke up at the top of the show, if this goes on for very long, then the critics will start to say, hey, you can't do anything with this guy. What's he going to do with Douglas? What's he going to do with Tyson? So he must start to wake up and start to put pressure much more than he's doing now.
Solid left by Holyfield. McDonough comes back. Sorting him. That right was a grazer by McDonough. It didn't land on Holyfield's chin.
But it is catching his attention.
Oh, McDonough showing a lot of heart. Under 20 seconds in the third round. McDonough coming back from being knocked down twice in the first. Holyfield could not put him away. Another sharp shot to the ribs by Holyfield. Sounds to end the third.
Which is what he's got to show. Sheamus has got to put those punches out there to keep Holyfield away. And, of course, in spurts, he does that. But the majority of the times, he's eating leather. Let's look at it from a different angle. See that broad back and that barrel chest that he's got? He's got to use that. He's got to try to out-bully and out-strengthen Holyfield, but he just simply cannot do it.
Scheduled for 12, the WBC Continental America's Heavyweight Championship. Third defense by Holyfield. How does your scorecard look right now?
Dismal for Sheamus. It's 30-25 for Holyfield. I gave that first round a 10-7 because of two knockdowns. Again, the hard punches have got Sheamus rocking. But he's fighting back.
Down goes McDonough through the ring.